Can you guys tell I got a new background? Can you guys also tell I'm out of focus? I'm a mess. Foundation! And this one's by Morphe. What? And she's not drinking the PSL? What? It's gonna be a great basic day regardless. Don't even worry about it. I'm gonna go ahead and start priming my face. I've already moisturized, but I still feel that I need to moisturize a little bit. We are going through a heat wave. No, yeah, we are. It's 109 degrees outside. That ain't normal. So I'm going to mix a little bit of my Milani Prime and Protect SPF 30 Face Primer. And I'm going to mix it with my Nivea Men's Post Sensitive Shave Balm.
And this is gonna work as our primer today. So many videos to film today. So many things to do today. I have to go to the grocery store with makeup on under a mask.
Shoot me now. Also gonna go ahead and spray my Urban Decay All Nighter Ultra Matte Long Lasting Setting Spray. You guys know that do be my hack to making my makeup last all day, or at least last longer than usual, because I don't wear makeup all day, but you guys know what I'm saying. I'm not a Morphe affiliate. This was a product that was purchased by me, and I was actually not the most curious to try it. Like, I'm gonna be very honest. I usually start these videos and I'm like, I was so curious to try this, I couldn't wait. But this was actually more so you guys really asking me to review it. I got a couple DMs. I could totally understand why a lot of people are curious about this foundation. It's supposed to be like a foundation that's like a BB cream serum, and it's supposed to be super lightweight, super breathable. It's supposed to like hit all the targets, hit all the marks, and be super blowing of the mind. Honestly, I can understand why you guys are like about it. I will say, however, she definitely got her wrong skin shade. I usually buy any shade that says honey because I feel like that is what I am, even though I think honey's kind of gross. I'm just spitting the truth. Y'all wanted honesty. Calm down your panties and your bees, please. But this one is, I think, a little bit too dark. You guys can't see how dark it is because these lights are super finessing this shade. But I think I got it a little bit too dark. The only thing that I think is gonna be on my side is this is a sheer foundation and not a full coverage foundation. So it's not gonna be an Estee Lauder double wear where you're clearly gonna see me wearing a mask. And the way this neck is looking, like it would just red out on me, and I don't want that. But like I said, it's a sheer to medium coverage foundation, so I don't think it's gonna be that bad. But if I do be looking trifling, don't say anything, guys. I'm really, just keep it to yourselves. We're reviewing the formula, and I usually do very good at this, I know. Also, my skin doesn't know what to do right now. It's still hot outside, it's still super sunny. I feel like I'm still getting darker, but at the same time I'm also getting lighter because there's also a lot of clouds. But then again, don't UV rays go through clouds? I don't know. Go ask your dad. The packaging says this is a lightweight, breathable formula, hydrates, smooths, and blurs. It's non-comedogenic. It is vegan. And it says to apply, shake gently, start with 1 to 2 drops, and build to your desired level of coverage. Apply using a synthetic brush, sponge, or your fingers. Well, we're absolutely not gonna use our fingers, so. Let's use our toes. I kind of want to use this with a brush. I'm going to use this one from Ulta, which was the Frida Kahlo Ulta little collaboration. Okay, so I shooketh it pretty gently. It does come with a dropper, and I'm going to tell you right now, I don't like the packaging of this. It's already getting super dirty and gross. Oh, that is liquidy. Oh, like in my mind, I know I'm dark, but I'm also like not that dark. Una cosa es Juan Dominguez, otra cosa es John Smith. And I feel like I'm kind of in between both. Like, I'm not that dark, but I'm also not that light. And I put 2 drops, if I'm not mistaken, on the back of my hand. Okay, so this is what 1 thin layer is looking like. So this is the foundation. This is no foundation. So the coverage is super light, guys. There's obviously something there, but it's super sheer right now. I could definitely see so much of my freckles, so many of like my moles, just my veins, and my actual skin still peeking through, which as I've mentioned so many times, I sound like a broken tape recorder or just recorder. I don't know, go ask your mom. But I love that. I love seeing my skin peek through. I'm not the biggest fan of full coverage. Again, there I go sounding all broken again. I like to look pretty like natural and glowy and hoey. Sometimes just hoey and hoey. I'm not even gonna lie. Okay, so that's what we're looking like. What do we think? I'm gonna tell you guys right now, I super like it, totally like it. And thank God, again, that this is a sheer product, because if this was a full coverage or even a medium coverage beat, I would be looking split tone, Oompa Loompa, and Paper from the movie Paper. 2 more drops. Okay, guys, I really really like this. At least right now, it's looking really good. I see the blurring. I definitely feel that it's just the most lightweight thing ever. And it definitely doesn't feel drying or heavy or thick or anything like that. It actually, like, it feels phenom. But I'm gonna go ahead and probably go and do my brows, do my concealer. I'm gonna be using my Makeup Forever concealer because it's one of my favorite concealers at the moment. And then we will touch base and see how we're looking after everything is done. I'll tell you guys how it's wearing, how it's looking, all that good stuff. Okay, so don't get mad at me. I actually had to leave yesterday in a hurry. So yesterday is when I first filmed the video that you just watched. But I'm actually happy that I did that because I lived in the foundation long enough to really tell you guys what's what. And here are my final thoughts on the Morphe Pin Hint Skin Tint Foundation. It's good, guys. This is really good. I'm not a Morphe affiliate. I'm pretty sure Morphe has no idea who I am. I've never been contacted by their team. Don't even really talk about their products that much on my channel. And I wasn't expecting to like this at all, in the least. I am not the biggest fan of dropper foundations, to be honest with you guys. Like, I'm not. I like liquid, regular old meat and potatoes type of foundation. I don't know why I use that expression. But I love this foundation. I'm wearing it right now. And when I tell you, this has like the prettiest, most skin-like appearance. And even though I wore this with a sponge today, not a brush, because yesterday, remember, I wore a brush. Hold on, my nose itches. I used it with a brush today just to see what was gooch with it, and it still looks really, really good. I will say using it with a brush made it a lot more matte. The dampness of my beauty sponge today, by the way, I think this one's from e.l.f. This actually made it a little bit more luminous and a little bit more hydrating, which if you guys have dry skin, that's another trick. But if you guys are oily like me, I would actually recommend using a brush, which is so weird. Yo, I always use damp sponges for my foundation. But I think with this foundation, I'm always gonna try and opt for a brush if I have one that is clean and available. This is such a good foundation. I am gonna give you guys my wholehearted stamp of approval on it. I am actually going to go ahead and order this in a lighter skin shade and use this as my winter foundation because it's just that good. It's so good. It's not mattifying, but once you set it down and if you prep your skin really well, if you have oily skin, and that's a big if, you can still make it work for your oily skin. Mattifying foundations over time can tend to just be more harm than good, so I do actually always advise a more hydrating foundation no matter what type of skin type you have. But I understand that it could be scary when you have oily skin, but I'm just telling you right now that if you prep correctly and if you prime and if you set really well, this shouldn't move, because this foundation wore on me until 9 o'clock at night last night, and I stopped filming at, I want to say, 2 in the afternoon. So that's a good 7 hour wear. The only reason it started breaking up on my nose is because that's where I get the most oiliest. But with knowing that, I primed a little differently today, and I definitely used a more mattifying spray. I'm gonna go ahead and leave you guys with that. I'm sorry that I forgot to film the ending yesterday, but again, all happy accidents here, yo, because I give you guys an even better review, I feel, because I spent like all day yesterday and I could tell you guys like what it do. I might do that more, honestly. It looked real good, and honestly, like, she looks good. I got so many compliments on the video where I wore it, which was my what's in my travel bag. So many compliments on my skin, and it's this foundation, guys. I'm hype for this foundation. I think everybody should try it out. Honestly, if you have dry skin, you're probably gonna love it. I do gotta get going though. I got a date with Jack in the Box, so. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Sorry for being so scattered and about. She did have a PSL today, or two, maybe three.